Welcome to the video lectures on course Radiation and Microwave Techniques. In the previous lecture, we have started with Unit 6, that is Microwave Systems and Microwave Measurement Techniques. So in this second lecture, we are going to go through the microwave applications. Let's see what are the contents that will be covered. Learning outcomes, applications in the areas like microwave heating, thickness measurement, moisture measurement, and one of the medical application, that is microwave diathermy. Coming to learning outcome, after completion of lecture, students will be able to understand different applications of microwaves in microwave heating, thickness measurement, moisture measurement, and the medical application microwave diathermy. So let's start with the microwave application. First microwave application, that is microwave heating. Microwave heating, it uses electromagnetic energy in the frequency range of 300 to 3000 megahertz. Microwave heating is usually applied at most popular of the frequency allowed for industrial, scientific, and the medical applications, namely 915 megahertz and 2450 megahertz. Domestic microwave ovens are familiar examples operating at 2.4 gigahertz. The way in which a material will be heated by the microwave, it depends upon its shape, size, and the dielectric constant and the nature of the microwave equipment used. Let's see application of microwave heating and microwave oven. A microwave oven is an electric oven that heats and cooks food by exposing it to electromagnetic radiation in the microwave frequency range. So you can see in the figure, he is Dr. Percy Spencer. So the cavity magnetron, it was developed by the John Randall and Harry Boot in 1940. So while experimenting on the magnetron in 1945, the heating effect of the high power microwave beam was accidentally discovered by this person, Dr. Percy Spencer. He is an American self-taught engineer from Holland. He noticed that microwaves from an active radar set he was working on started to melt a chocolate bar he had in his pocket. So the first food deliberately cooked with the Spencer's microwave was popcorn, and the second was an egg. So he was the person behind the accidental discovery of microwave oven. So here is one of the video. The link of the video is provided over here.
Behold, the microwave. But where did it come from? Meet Percy LeBaron Spencer, born in Maine in 1894. Percy grew up with his aunt and uncle, and by the time he was 12, he'd left school to apprentice at a mill. In the Navy, he studied wireless telegraphy, and when he joined the Raytheon Company in the 1920s, he established himself as an electrical genius. His improvements to magnetrons boosted production from 17 per day to over 2,500 per day. But his biggest inspiration struck in 1945 when an operating magnetron melted the chocolate bar inside his pocket. When Percy placed popcorn in front of the beam, the kernels popped. He wondered, could it be possible to cook food using microwave radiation? Raytheon knew a good thing when they saw it, and in 1954 the company began selling an innovative little gadget called the microwave oven. Of course, the original microwave oven weighed 750 pounds and stood over 5 feet tall. This first microwave oven model was called the Radarange. Microwave ovens use radio waves with a frequency of about 2.5 gigahertz. At this frequency, radio waves are absorbed by sugars, water, and fats, but not by most plastics, ceramics, or glass. These waves are converted into heat when they're absorbed, which means that a microwave oven essentially only heats the food. As a side note, metal will reflect microwaves, which is why you shouldn't use metal plates or foil in these devices. After decades of research, improvement, and a lot of miniaturization, the microwave oven became a common sight in kitchens across the world.
So So this was the short video related to the invention of microwave oven. But now let's see how the microwave oven works. You can see in the figure there is the internal structure of microwave oven is shown. Microwave oven is commonly used for cooking purpose without using water. So high energy of microwave rotate the polar molecules of water, fat and sugars of the foodstuff. The rotation causes friction that results in the heat generation, and this process is called as dielectric heating. The excitation by the microwaves is almost uniform so that the food will heat up uniformly. The cooking in the microwave oven is fast, efficient and safe. A microwave oven, as shown in the figure, it consists of a high voltage transformer that passes energy into the magnetron. A magnetron chamber, there is a magnetron control unit and a waveguide and this cooking chamber. The energy in the microwave oven has a frequency of 2.45 GHz with wavelength of 12.24 cm. The microwaves propagate as alternating cycles so that the polar molecules, that is one end is positive and the other end is negative, align themselves according to the alternating cycles, and the self-alignment causes rotation of these polar molecules, and the rotating polar molecules hit other molecule and put them into motion. The microwave induced heating is more efficient if the tissue has high water content, since there are free water molecules to rotate. Fat, sugar, frozen water, etc. show less dielectric heating due to the presence of less free water molecules. The microwave cooks the outer part of the food first and then the inner part, similar to the ordinary cooking using a flame. In this way, the microwave oven, it works. Now let's see another application of microwave heating in cancer treatment. So the microwave heating is also used in curing the cancer. Particularly, it is used in hypothermic oncology. This type of cancer therapy involves subjecting tumor tissues to localized heating without damaging the healthy tissues around it. Doctor performing microwave coagulation therapy inserts a thin microwave antenna directly into the tumor and they heat it up. The microwave heating, it generates a coagulated region, killing those cancerous cells. This treatment method requires controlling the spatial distribution and the heating power also. The temperature sensors, they must be both well designed and strategically placed in order to avoid the harming healthy tissues. So basically, this microwaves, they can be advantageous as well as they can be disadvantageous. If they are used in a limited manner, they can be used for treating cancer, as well as if they are exposed for a longer duration of time, they can also cause damage to the healthy tissues. So now let's move on to the second applications of microwaves, that is in thickness measurement. In industry, frequently it is required to measure the sheet thickness of the rolling metal sheets, as shown in the figure. The measurement setup is given in the slide. The setup is using two horns, as you can see, these are the two horn antennas facing each other with a gap in between them. The metal sheet during the rolling process is passed between these two horns. One of the horn is used as a transmitter and the other one is used as a receiver of the microwaves. The microwaves transmitted by one of the horn, they strike the metal sheet. Depending upon the thickness, the reflection of the wave is decided. The horns, they are connected to two waveguides that are again connected to the two port or a three port circulator. In the figure, there is a three port circulator. The third port of the circulator, it is connected to the reflection coefficient measurement system. A phase shifter is also introduced in one of the waveguide arm connecting the horn with the circulator. The waveguide along with the circulator, phase shifter and the horn, they form a cavity whose resonance frequency can be varied by adjusting the phase shifter. The phase shifter is adjusted so that the resonant cavity has resonance frequency equal to the signal frequency for a given metal thickness. This ensures the minimum reflection coefficient at the measurement plane. In case if the metal thickness is changed, then the measured reflection coefficient deviates from its minimum value. By noting the variation in the measured reflection coefficient, the variation in the sheet thickness can be estimated. But if the metal thickness is uniform, then any changes in the position of the metal plate will not change the overall cavity length, and hence there will be no effect on the measurement. In this way, the thickness of the metal sheet is calculated in the rolling machine. Now here you can pause the video and check for the theory related to thickness measurement of metal sheet and rolling machine. Let's move to the second application in thickness measurement, that is for measurement of thickness of dielectric material. The thickness of dielectric metal sheet can be measured by using the same setup as of the thickness measurement of metal sheet. The difference is here the transmission coefficient is measured, which depends upon the thickness of dielectric material. If the thickness of dielectric changes, it will be reflected in the measured transmission coefficient. If the indicating meter is calibrated in the terms of dielectric thickness, then the dielectric thickness it can be measured directly. Now let's move to the third application of microwaves in moisture measurement. Moisture content measurement is a very important process to produce good quality material products. Microwaves have property that they travel through non-conductive materials. In materials with bipolar molecular structure like water, the electric field of microwaves can induce oscillation while traveling through the medium. During this process, the microwave loses some of the energy. The loss of energy increases with the amount of water that medium contains, with the result that as the water concentration increases, less energy will reach on the other side of medium. Water not only absorbs but also reflects some of the microwave energy. By utilizing this effect, that is the reflection and absorption, one is able to perform moisture measurement with microwaves. So this is the setup for moisture content measurement in solid material. The sample to be analyzed, it is placed in between the microwave emitter and the microwave detector. Two horn antennas, they are used for this purpose. A moist sample of thickness L is placed in between the two axially mounted the horn antennas. One of the horn antenna emits radiation which passes through the sample. The sample causes change in the phase and the attenuation of transmitted microwave beam. The phase shift in radian and the attenuation in decibel depends upon the moisture content in the sample. Measuring the attenuation and phase shift, the moisture content in the sample, it can be determined. So this is the typical setup for moisture content measurement in solid material. You can pause the video and check for theory. Then we will see the moisture content measurement in liquid. Here you can see in the figure the magic T junction is used. The E plane of magic T junction is connected to the microwave source and the H arm is connected to the detector. The remaining two collinear arms of the magic T, they are connected to the two identical cavities, the tube through which the liquid is allowed to pass as an integral part of the cavity. The liquid under test is allowed to pass through one of the cavity and a moisture-free reference liquid is allowed to pass through the other cavity. The cavity is designed in such a way that the electric field is maximum along the axis of tube. If the moisture is present in the test liquid, then the resonance frequency and the reflection coefficient of the cavities will be different and the detector output will deviate from a null condition. On the other hand, if liquid under test is moisture free, then a resonance frequency of the cavities will be identical and detector will show a null. If the output meter is calibrated in the terms of moisture, then the moisture content can be measured directly. In this way, the moisture content in a liquid can be measured. Again, here the theory related to this moisture content measurement in liquid is given. Now let's see the last application that is in the medical field, that is microwave diathermy. What is diathermy? This diathermy is a Greek word in which therma means heat and dia means through. So diathermy means heating through. In diathermy, high frequency electrical currents, they are used. The figure is showing you the setup for doing the treatment of microwave diathermy. Diathermy involves heating deep muscular tissue. When heat is applied to the painful areas, the cellular metabolism, it speeds up and the blood flow increases. Doctors also uses diathermy in surgical procedures for sealing blood vessels with electrically heated probes. Microwave diathermy systems, they are typically set at 2.45 gigahertz. Diathermy is used to treat the following condition: arthritis, back pain, muscle pain, spasms, myositis, neuralgia, sprains and strains, and etc. According to the difference in the absorbability of the tissues, the clinical effect of microwave radiation depends upon the type of tissues involved. Tissues with low water content are penetrated to the greater depth, and the tissues with high water content are penetrated to lesser depth. Absorption of wave results in the production of heat in the tissues, but differs from the other heat treatment methods in the distribution of heat. Electromagnetic energy is transferred into heat energy. The effective depth of microwave penetration is about 3 cm. As the microwaves, they are strongly absorbed by the water, tissues with high fluid contents are heated most, while the less heat is produced for the tissues with low fluid content, as the fats or the bones. Moreover, this is an appreciable heating of tissues having a good blood supply, such as muscle. The benefit of diathermy is that it is a painless procedure that can be administered at a clinic. Also, if the treatment relieves pain, then the patient can discontinue the painkillers and escape their high cost and side effects of the tablets. So in this way, the microwave can be used for treating the pain of different body muscles. In this lecture, we have seen different applications of microwaves in various fields, including microwave heating. We saw the application of microwave oven, how the microwave oven works and how it cooks food, and also related to the moisture content measurement in the solids as well as liquids, and the thickness measurement also we have seen. And at last, we saw the application in the medical field, that is medical diathermy. Thank you.